An electrocardiogram is otherwise called an EKG, and it's done just to get a routine assessment of what's going on in your heart.
An electrocardiogram is a painless procedure. The patient can expect to lie down flat and stickers be placed on their chest, and a recording will be done by the medical staff.
If you have symptoms concerning for cardiac manifestations, so you have chest pain, you have palpitations, sometimes for some people it's epigastric pain, sometimes you might pass out. Those are things that would make us get concerned about, okay, well, let's get an EKG, get a baseline, see what's going on. And then sometimes we do serial EKGs over time to see has anything changed. Sometimes it's done routinely as part of investigation for health insurance or disability. Or they just want to be sure that before doing the procedure, you know, your heart has no underlying issues. It's one of the most routine tests that we do in cardiology.
A cardiac stress test is an exercise test where we put the patient on a treadmill or give a patient medication to simulate stress on the heart so the doctor can assess the electrical conduction system and the blood flow to the heart when the heart is under stress. A doctor may refer a patient for a cardiac stress test if the patient has been experiencing symptoms such as chest pain, shortness of breath, or a doctor may refer a patient to a cardiac stress test prior to surgery to make sure the patient's heart is healthy enough to undergo whatever surgery they need. The patient will be asked to go on an exercise treadmill and walk for a certain amount of minutes, or they may be given a medication to simulate stress on their heart. And after that, pictures are taken of the heart to make sure that the heart is functioning well and the blood flow to the heart is appropriate.
When you're referred to a cardiologist for cardiac testing, I know it's a little concerning. People get worried. We don't want you getting worried. We're gonna talk to you based on what symptoms you have, and then we'll discuss what is appropriate, what tests are appropriate, and what do we need to get done. Based on all that, we're going to get you feeling better. We're going to get to the reason of what's going on and then hopefully get you to a place where you feel you've gotten the excellent care you deserve.